In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and warm welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's readings. It's the 9th of February, Sunday of the 5th week in ordinary time. So today we begin the 5th week in the ordinary time. We have three readings today. The first reading from Prophet Isaiah chapter 58 verses 7 to 10. Then we have the Psalm from 112. Then we have the Gospel from Matthew chapter 5 verses 13 to 16. And the second reading is from St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians chapter 2 verse 1 to 5. So let's read this letter, the second reading, and try to reflect on the same. When I came to you, brethren, I did not come proclaiming to you the testimony of God in lofty words or wisdom. For I decided to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. And I was with you in weakness and in much fear and trembling. And my speech and my message were not in plausible words of wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power, that your faith might not rest in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. St. Paul paints an interesting picture of himself in this reading. He tells the Christians in Corinth that when he came to preach the gospel to them, he came in weakness and fear and much trembling. This doesn't correspond to the super apostle and miracle worker image that we tend to have of St. Paul. Even the reason why he wrote this first letter to the Corinthians doesn't fit with that Herculean image. He wrote the letter because he had to defend himself against critics who were turning the Christians in Corinth against him. But his self-defense is kind of strange, isn't it? My dear friend, St. Paul doesn't point to any special achievements or outstanding personal qualities. Instead, he points to his weakness and his lack of special qualities. It is as if he was saying, I did not graduate from prestigious colleges or win any major awards. From a strictly human perspective, I don't have any qualifications or credentials. It's almost as if he is agreeing with his critics. But then he makes his point, which is very simple and very important. Precisely because he was such an unimpressive figure, they know that the gospel he preached is true. It is based on God's power, he says, not human wisdom. The faith of the Christians in Corinth and the faith of every Christian, including ourselves, needs to be built on the unshakable foundation of God and His revelation, not on fancy arguments, emotional comforts, or human satisfactions. Today, each one of us needs to ask ourselves, what is the foundation of my Catholic faith? What kind of foundation am I building on? God's power or fragile human wisdom? Three litmus tests can help us answer this question accurately. First, prayer. Do I take time out of my busy schedule to spend with God in prayer every day? Do I even know how to pray? Do I pray better now than I did 10 years ago? If other things, even good things, continuously crowd personal, heartfelt prayer out of our daily life, we can be sure that we are not building on God's power. Second, obedience. Christ's path of redemption was traveled through obedience to his Father's will, even to the point of dying on the cross. As his followers, we are also called to be obedient to God's will, even when it's hard. We can ask ourselves, am I obeying all of the Ten Commandments, or do I habitually break one or two of them? Am I obeying church teaching regarding the tough issues of our day, like abortion, contraception, divorce and remarriage, and every Catholic's duty to evangelize? Do I even know the reasons behind those teachings? Obedience is a truly fundamental Christian virtue. Third, the sacraments. If we eagerly look forward and prepare ourselves to receive Christ in the Eucharist each Sunday, and if we make use of the amazing sacrament of confession on a regular basis, most preferably monthly, that is a sure sign that we are building our lives on God's power, not fragile human wisdom. My dear friends, today Abhishek Borge from Mumbai and Viraj Singh from Kadra Karwar, Justisha Sani Fernandez from Vamanjur, Sylvia Pinto from Mumbai are celebrating their birthdays. We wish them happy birthday, and also all the others among the listeners of Carmel Light who celebrate their birthday today. Wish you all a happy birthday. May God bless you. It's also the wedding anniversary of Robert and Wilma DeCosta from Mumbai. Congratulations, my dear friends. May God bless your family life. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Have a great Sunday, my dear friends. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.